This is the Positive Psychology Project by Aaron and Enzo. Do you consider yourself happy? Why or why not? These are the questions we asked a number of teenagers, most of which are in high school, to see what answers we would get. Overall, people said they were happy because of having supportive friends and family, financial stability, having the things they wanted, and being grateful for the opportunities they had. They also mentioned the things that made life difficult, such as school and toxic relationships. These things can make life for a teenager pretty hard. So how can people cope with these kinds of situations? Well, a lot of times, people think of happiness as something we have to find, or something we can't control. But that's not the case. We're all in control, though there are some factors we can't decide, such as genetics. And that brings us to the happiness pie chart made by Sonia Libermirsky, Kenan M. Sheldon, and David Schade. I'm sorry if I butchered those names. As you can see, 50% of our happiness is determined by our genetics, or happiness set point. 40% by our intentional activities, and 10% by our circumstances. Our happiness set point, as Dr. L. calls it, is our genetically determined predisposition for happiness. It's like a happiness level we're born with, and everyone's set point is different. Ever known someone who's naturally cheerful or optimistic? They probably have a higher set point. Intentional activities is basically what we do to make ourselves happy. The hobbies we have, the activities we like doing, and even the people we hang out with. Circumstances is just that. Our life circumstances. Our families, where we live, the schools we go to, etc. Now what does all this mean? Well, for one, it gives us a better perspective. We know there are some things we can't control, but there are still things we can do to make ourselves happier. Such as writing down 3 good things about the day before going to bed. This is an exercise made by Martin Seligman, an American psychologist. This exercise helps us focus on the positive moments rather than the negative ones. Other ways include challenging negative thoughts, meditation, and performing random acts of kindness. To learn more, you can go to MindLab for How to Be Happier, 5 Techniques from Positive Psychology. Now, I want to bring us back to that pie chart. You'll notice there are some things missing, some things we'd normally assume would make us happier, like having a relationship, having all the stuff we want, more money, more time. None of these things are there, and for good reason. None of these things are going to make us any more happy. They may make us happier for a little while, but it doesn't last. Not to say being in a relationship is bad, but you don't need one to be happy. Life doesn't have to be centered around finding that one special person. The same goes for having things. It's not going to make life any more fulfilling. We can be happy even if we don't live lavish lives, drive sports cars, or have the video games we want. With all that said, happiness isn't easy. It's a process we all go through. It may be long and difficult, but it's always worth it in the end. Just keep going, and you'll make it. Thank you for watching, and I hope this was helpful. Bye now.